Good morning, students. I am going to start chapter 6, energy and power resources. Chapter 1, 2, 3 I have discussed. 4 and 5 I am not doing now because these two chapters are the part of your second semester. Okay, so directly I am going to start chapter 6 now because it is your part of first semester. So 1, 2, 3 and now 6. So chapter 6, energy and power resources. First, I have given you some homework. You just note down and I want to see this answer in your copy. From exercise, I have given some question. Question number 1. A, B, C, D, E. 5 words are there. That one you have to define or discuss. Your first question, if you follow the exercise, it is define the following terms. And 5 terms are there, which one you have to define, have to write in your copy. And all answer you will get in the book and I am going to discuss now also. Question number 2. From that question 2, you will write A and B. It is short type question. That answer also you will get. And question 3, A and B. Question 4, only A. Question 4, if you follow, that is about differences. Two differences are there and I have given only one, that is number 1. Differences between conventional and non-conventional resources. This is your homework. One more homework I have given. World distribution of energy resources. You have to make one table in your copy. See the table. Two columns will be there. Okay, I have written. In first column you will write name of the energy resources. And in the second column you will write distribution. In case of name of the energy resources, we will get two categories, non-renewable and renewable. Under non-renewable, A and B, two examples are there, coal and petroleum. And non-renewable, three examples given, like solar energy, wind energy and hydropower. Okay. And you have to find out their locations. Okay. Total five energy resources given. So, you have to find out their location. Here I have mentioned first four locations or names. If you follow the book, all examples given, location given, many are there. But which one you will write? You will write first four. You will prepare first four names of coal, location of coal or distributing area of coal, petroleum, like first four you have to write. So this table also I want to see in your copy. So this is your overall homework, which one you have to done. In your copy, it will be checked after reopening the school. So, homework I have given. Now, I am going to explain one by one about the topic. And you will get the answer when you will do the homework. So, now I am going to start the topic. Energy and power resources. What are the meaning of resources? Resources means, you can say, resources are something which can fulfill our need. I repeat, resources are something which can fulfill our need. Many examples of resources all of you know. Because morning to night, so many things we are using every day and they are the example of resources. But it can be two types, man-made and natural. And example, different types of examples are there and I know all of you know the examples of resources. But here we are going to discuss about a particular resource and the name of the resource is energy or power resource. So what is the meaning of energy or power resource? Actually, these are the type of resources from where we are getting energy or power. And it is very important in different fields. This energy or this power, very important in different field means in agriculture we need the energy, in industry we need the energy, transport we need energy, in houses, in defense, everywhere we need the energy. So we are going to know about those resources from where we can generate energy or power. So now I am going to discuss about it. First, types of energy. It can be two types, non-renewable and renewable. Here I have written. What is the meaning of these two words? Non-renewable means cannot be renewed. And renewable means can be renewed. All of you know about it. Non-renewable means it is a natural resource that cannot be readily replaced by nature. I repeat, non-renewable resource is a natural resource that cannot be readily replaced by nature. Means if it finished, means you will never get back that one easily. That is non-renewable. And examples, all of you know, coal, petroleum, these are the example of non-renewable. If it finished once, then you will never get back. And these non-renewable resources also called conventional resource, means point number two, and renewed one called non-conventional one. I didn't discuss the renewable one. What is the renewable means? Renewable means can be renewed, means naturally it can be replenished, it will never finish. Naturally it can be replenished, that is renewable. Now non-renewable is called conventional one and renewable one is called non-conventional one. What is the meaning of these two terms, conventional and non-conventional? Conventional means it is used traditionally. I have written used since ancient times. People know about its importance and they use it. But non-conventional means it's recently discovered. Their importance, their uses recently discovered. That is the meaning of non-conventional. And now example, that one also you know. Renewable one like solar energy, wind energy, hydropower, hydroelectricity. So these are the example of renewable one. And one more characteristics they have in case of non-renewable, they are the cause of pollution. Why? Just now I have given coal, petroleum, and you know they contain carbon. So it is the cause of pollution. And renewable one like water, wind, they are free from pollution. I have written pollution free and here cause of pollution. So these are the few important characteristics of these two types of resources, renewable and non-renewable. Example wise many are there, but syllabus wise we will prepare only 5, and they are, if we talk about non-renewable, coal and petroleum we will prepare in the table, that's why I have written A and B. And renewable we will prepare only 3, that is solar, wind and hydro electricity. And what we will prepare? Only their distribution we will prepare. Done. That distribution we will prepare. So I have done this table, I have formed that table, you will fill up that one. Now I told you that syllabus wise we will know about only 5 types of energy resources, and on only distribution of those energy resources, means where they are found, we will prepare, not more than that. And definitely there are many, though I have given that homework, but except coal. Our first example of non-renewable energy, just now I said it is coal. So in about the coal, we are going to know some detailed way. Coal basically 4 types, you know, the most important thermal energy. Use number of, even you can say whole world use this resource as a power resource or energy resource. So it can be 4 type, coal actually basically 4 types according to the carbon quantity. Because coal contain carbon, and somewhere it is very high, somewhere it is less, in some case of it is very medium. So on the basis of that concept, carbon quantity, we are getting 4 types of coal: peat, lignite, bituminous and anthracite. I repeat, peat, lignite, bituminous and anthracite. Out of this 4, peat actually lowest rank of coal because it contain less amount of carbon. And its heating capacity also very less because carbon content is less. Anthracite, last one, if you talk about it, it is actually the highest rank of coal because it contains more iron. By nature it is very hot, color wise it is black. So that is anthracite. If we talk about the lignite, it is actually called soft coal or brown coal color wise. Okay, it is mainly used to generate electricity, lignite one. And bituminous one, bituminous actually popularly known commercial coal. Okay, it is used for commercial purpose. So we people use four types of coal, but if we talk about the carbon content, anthracite is the best one, and this one, the peat one, is the lowest rank one. So these are the four types of coal. And now its distribution, I have already given the homework. You will find out in this whole world where basically coal is found or located, extracted or located. And the last part of the chapter, that is conservation of energy resources. Page number I have marked on 65 given in detail. But what is the meaning of conservation of energy resources? Conservation means conserve the resource from being depletion. Okay. Or protect the energy resources from being depletion. Why? Because this energy resource is the basic requirement of, or you can say energy resource is the basic requirement for economic development of a country. I repeat, energy resource or resources are basic requirement for economic development of a country. So we should conserve it from being depletion, especially non-renewable one. Okay, and in that case, which steps we can follow? There are four steps. We can follow the reuse, recycle and reduce method, 3R, and we can avoid, as a second point you can say, we can avoid the wastage of resources. Okay, we can use the public transport more than the private one. Okay. And we can use renewable one more than the non-renewable, because renewable one can be renewed and it is pollution free. So we should use more renewable resource than the non-renewable one. So if we follow these four steps, we can conserve the energy resource. So this is the total chapter, very small, even you can say smallest chapter, very easy one, and homework already I have given. So you go through the chapter, find out your doubts, and through the WhatsApp you can ask me. But once again I want to say, this homework, the answer of these questions I want to see in your copy. Okay, thank you. Okay student, one thing I forgot to discuss, that is about the examples of two non-renewable and three renewable resources. Two non-renewable resources are coal and petroleum. I told about them. These two actually available under the surface. That's why they contain huge amount of carbon and cause of pollution. And these two are the examples of fossil fuels, coal and petroleum. But renewable, they are free from pollution, and the examples are solar energy, wind energy and hydroelectricity. Solar energy, all of you know, this energy is generated by trapping of solar radiation by using solar cells, solar cooker, solar water heater, etc. Means the main source of this energy is sun, which is applicable in equatorial and tropical area. Done. Next one is wind energy. Wind energy actually generated in the windmill. What is windmill? You will get one idea if you see page number 64. Photo is given. But these windmills are found where? In the coastal area. Why? Because coastal areas are free from any kinds of barrier or obstacles. No houses, no big buildings, trees, nothing. So winds can blow there with a very high speed, and that speed is very important to generate wind energy. And the last one is hydroelectricity. Students who are living in Maithan, they have very good idea about it. Hydroelectricity generated by movement of water with the help of one machine called turbine. But one feature is very important. Water is coming from high altitudinal area. Means certain height is important from where water is coming or falling. And with the help of the turbine machine, we can generate the hydroelectricity from that running water. So these are the three examples of an explanation of these renewable resources. Done. If it is not clear, so through WhatsApp you can ask me.